Hello everybody, it's Soggy back, and here is another video for the last 5 or 6 weeks of my acquisitions for my gaming collection. This first one here you already see in front of me, and you, is Rhythm Tengoku for the Game Boy Advance. It's the first game in the series known westward as Rhythm Heaven, and I wanted to start with something with the first game in the series, even though this one never came west at all, but I was just interested in trying this one first, especially since it's going to be the most simplistic one by nature, because it doesn't involve touchscreen inputs like the DS1 or any other motion inputs like other versions that we did get over in the west. So that's what this one is, and I wanted to eager to try it out. I've been looking for it for a while, and got a nice copy right here, complete everything. Next up is one of the holy grails of PC Engine collecting, and I finally got myself a copy of this. Akumajou Dracula X Rondo of Blood, or Chino Rondo as the actual box says. We did get this in the West on PSP and on Virtual Console, if I'm not mistaken, for the Wii. And that's kind of the PSP version specifically, because that's one I already had. Kind of put me off on getting the real thing for a while, but since it has gone down in value for good reason because of those other aforementioned versions being released over in the West, it made it a lot cheaper for me to get a copy of this. And this copy is quite minty, so I didn't necessarily expect that or require it, but it's very nice when it happens. And the Obi's there and everything, so it's pretty awesome. Next up is a middling game called Valis 2. This did come over to the West back in the day, but since I go for most of the Japanese releases because they're just generally easier to find and cheaper, even though the system is still a bit of a pricey thing to collect for at times, but just got a copy of that. Nothing super special. Next up is a brand new sealed game that I did unwrap, of course, because I don't really care about being sealed. It's just what I was presented when I ended up buying it, and it wasn't all that expensive to get it sealed. So this is a new copy of Armed F. So it's kind of interesting to open up new games when they're really not new at all. But it's a shoot 'em up, by the way, as most things are on that system. Here's another one. This is one of the ones I've had when I had a TurboGrafx-16 back in the early 90s. One of the games we had for the US system was Galaga 90, and this is the Japanese version called Galaga 88, simply because, well, it was released about a year and a half, 2 years earlier over there, so it makes sense. But I'm glad to finally have a copy of this again, because it's really, in my opinion, the best Galaga that there is, and I really enjoy it quite a bit. It gives enough new, interesting, fresh content and mechanics, and just to the addition to the general gameplay of the original Galaga. So if you like the original Galaga and you have not tried this one, you can also play the arcade version, because the arcade version is what this is based on. Definitely give it a shot. I recommend it for sure. Another game from that I finally acquired that was something I also had back on the TurboGrafx-16 in the early 90s is this is known as Legendary Axe in the West, and this version is specifically Makyo Densetsu, and it's actually the same game that I want to say it was EGM, but I don't think it was actually. I think it was I don't even know. So I won't really say, but I know there's a magazine back then that gave it like their Game of the Year for 1989 or something like that, so I wouldn't go that far with this game, but it is pretty good, especially for 1989, so definitely check it out if you haven't already. And the final game for the PC Engine I acquired recently is Paranoia, this game west and is known as Psychosis. It's a pretty strange shoot 'em up, but big surprise is a shoot 'em up, so. But it's pretty interesting and fairly decent. Next up, we have my one PlayStation 1 game that I have gotten, and it's a good find on a fairly pricey game, and that is Panzer Bandit. It's essentially a Guardian Heroes knockoff for the PlayStation, and this game is pretty good. Not quite as good as Guardian Heroes, but similar to, but it's kind of similar to how also Gunstar Heroes on the Genesis. Well, then and then there was a game I also have in my PlayStation collection. Gosh, can't remember the name. I think it was Rapid Reload in Europe. I have the Japanese version. It's a different title. I think it's Gunner's Heaven, if I'm not mistaken. And that's kind of very Gunstar Heroes-esque, and that's kind of weird that these two games are, you know, very much parallels to much more popular, better games. But this one's still better than the quality of Gunner's Heaven, in my opinion. So, and well worth a try if you can get a good deal on it. Next up we have is some Saturn stuff. Starting out with Soko Seitokai Sonic Council. It's a fighting game, because I go for that poverty, as they say. So I get some of these more obscure fighters. And this one, from what I've already tried, is not too bad. It's pretty good for an unknown obscure fighter that never made it west. Another one I've been putting off for years is the Saturn port of Cyberbots by Capcom. It's the first time, I believe, that we had the appearance of Jin, that also appears in Marvel vs. Capcom games. So, but in this game, it doesn't seem like the pilot, which is what he is, one of many. You know, you pick him, pick a pilot, and you pick a mech that they, or a cyberbot, if you will, for them to pilot, and it seems more like, unless I'm wrong about this, it seems like the cyberbot that you pick is more determinative of what you, how you, what your fighter is like, rather than anything the pilot has to do with it. But I could be wrong. I haven't delved much into it, so. But that's my perspective from what I've seen. Next up is Saturn port of Afterburner 2. I actually have a few of these types of Sega Ages arcade ports that are done really well on the Saturn. And this is one of them. Another one is Galaxy Force 2. I actually have, did also buy a copy of OutRun, which was also sealed and new, but unfortunately it did not, it cannot boot at all, and so I got effectively a defective copy in spite of it being sealed, which sucks. So I'm still on the lookout for a Saturn version of OutRun. And the final Saturn game I got this time is yet another conversion of Street Fighters, because that's just what I do. And that's the Street Fighter collection for the Saturn, which includes ports of Super Street Fighter 2, Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, and specifically Street Fighter Alpha 2 Dash, I think it is in this one. At least that's what it says in the back. Now, I'm pretty sure this is the same version as what is known in the West as Street Fighter Alpha 2 Gold, but I could be wrong. But either way, I don't really care for Alpha 2 Gold. Or this version, which I'm pretty sure is the same thing. Because this collection did come west, and that's what it was called over here, so. But, yeah, Alpha 2 Gold, not so great, in my mind. The original Alpha 2, awesome. But, yeah. That's that. And then, lastly, we have a bunch of PS3 games. First is one that came with an art book as a pre-order bonus. And if you're aware of any recent pre-order bonus art books, you probably may know what it is. and that is Dragon's Crown. And there's the art book. Great art in this game, in spite of any gratuitous boobies. It's still fantastic artwork. And I'm really glad to have it. I've already actually played through the game and beaten it a few times with not only myself, but with others. But yeah, it's a whole lot of fun, and it's definitely worth checking out if you are into the idea of beat-em-ups with RPG elements. Especially really nice-looking ones like this one, that are actually pretty good. Next one we have is Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Finally picked this up. So it hit $20 recently new, so decided to finally pick it up. I've been lagging around this one and now I have it. So that's that, I guess. next one is a recent Best Buy sale that they had, and I picked up Infamous 2 from that. Was going to get Killzone 3, but they didn't have any copies, so boo-hoo for me, I guess. I enjoyed the first game quite a bit, but I've been dragging my heels on the sequel because it seemed a lot like the first, and there's nothing inherently wrong with that. It's just I wasn't jonesing for a similar game when I initially completed the first one. But now, sure, why not? Next is a game I didn't expect to come out here, and that's Hatsune Miku Project Diva F. I like rhythm games, music games. I've tried the demo for one of the PSP games that's only in Japan, and seemed decent enough, but, you know, I don't know. I'm not particularly excited for this one, but I picked it up anyway because knowing Sega, when you release obscure things like this in the West, the copies are hard to come by, so I decided to pick it up anyway. Next one we have here is the first cave game on the PS3, and it's a port of probably their, or at least arguably for most people, the best shoot 'em up they ever made, and that is Kitsui, and this version is Kitsui Kizuna Jigoku Tachi Extra. It's also on 360 and has been for at least 2 or 3 years, and this is the limited edition or whatever the hell you want to call it, which has a nice slipcover, and of course comes with the game itself and a Super Play Blu-ray with additional 2 discs of the soundtrack, which is really cool. We have the Super Play Blu-ray right there, and then we have this one here is the original OST, or original soundtrack, and this one is the Extra X Mode soundtrack arranged version, so. And it wasn't much more money than the standard edition, which is why I went ahead with that one. So that's very nice to have. Enjoy my cave games, and I don't have a 360 and of any version or from any region. And I know that Cave has done a ton of stuff on that system, and unfortunately I've had to miss out because I don't really want to buy a 360, I'm just not interested in spending the money. Even if some of those games are region-free and I could just buy a US copy or US version of the system that they're on, but that's how it go. I don't have to say. Second to last game here we have Dungeons & Dragons, Chronicle of Mystara, which is what it's known as in the U.S. and Europe. This version is the physical release of it in Japan, which is why I picked it up, and it came out significantly later, but physical games are always my bread and butter, so that's what I get when I can. This particular one is titled Dungeons & Dragons Mystara Eiyu Senki, I believe. So, that's that. It's just the same thing, but on disc. It's got, you know, the two Capcom Dungeons & Dragons arcade games, which was Tower of Doom and Shadow over Mystara. So, But if you want to pick it up a little west, you can on PSN and Xbox Live Arcade for about $15, I believe. And the final game is a JoJo's Bizarre Adventure All-Star Battle, or as it says, JoJo no Kimona Boken All-Star Battle. I don't expect this to come over, so I'm actually surprised that Capcom even got their new port of their fighter from 1999, you know, released in the U.S. again, but which I really love that game, and I'm a fair weather fan of JoJo, but part because I haven't read much. I haven't even completed any part of reading any of the manga because I don't have them all, but I am in the process of rectifying that right now. Trying to get a hold of the books 7 through 16 that was released in English of part 3. Hopefully I'll read those soon. So that's the plans for that. And of course, the more you know about a license, for a licensed game, obviously the, you know, more enjoyable it is for in a lot of ways. And this is a CyberConnect 2 game, so it's going to have a lot more flash than, you know, quality, but this is still the better game, well, the best game I ever played of theirs, let's be honest. There are a number of games that are pretty simplistic, and while this one isn't super technical or anything, it's certainly a lot better than, and gives a lot more variety and things you can do and interesting mechanics and all that compared to anything they've ever done that I've ever played before. So this should be fun, and I've played a little bit of it, and it seems that way, so that is my pickups for this time. Thanks for watching, guys.